This is a session on how to use a chi-square test of independence between two variables. Basically, we are going to analyze categorical data and try to sort out a relationship between two categorical variables. Problem at hand. Okay, so this is a problem wherein we have two categorical variables, smoking and illness. Okay, so the results of a recent study regarding the smoking and three types of illness are shown in the following table. So this is the breakup of 300 people, and you can see that these 300 people have been visualized as having three types of illness and categorized into smokers and non-smokers. So out of 300, 120 are non-smokers and 180 are smokers. Similarly, out of 300, people suffering from emphysema is 80, heart problem is 150, and cancer is 70. Now, given this breakup, we are interested in finding out whether or not illness is independent of smoking. So, the problem is to first identify what is the null hypothesis and what is the alternate hypothesis. Okay. So, my null hypothesis, which is denoted by H0, here is illness is independent of smoking. Now, why illness is independent of smoking is considered as null hypothesis? Because for null hypothesis, we do not consider any kind of relationship between the variables. That's why it is called as null hypothesis. Just the opposite of that is the alternate hypothesis, which is stated as illness is not independent of smoking. Now, the procedure for carrying out chi-square test is as follows. If you see in the problem, we have been given the observed frequencies. That means something which is in between the intersection of the two variables. They are the breakup of the respondents, okay, across two different categories or variables. So all those are the observed frequencies. Now, corresponding to that, we have to calculate the expected frequency. So the expected frequency can be calculated, let's say, for expected frequency for the section where it is non-smokers and illness is equal to emphysema. The expected frequency would be 120 into 80 by 300. That means the corresponding column total and the row into the row total divided by the grand total. Okay, so corresponding column total into row total by the grand total. So it is 120 into 80 by 300. Similarly, we calculate expected frequency for all the other corresponding sections. Again, for instance, if we take the section of emphysema and smokers, so you see the observed frequency is 60. Corresponding to that, the expected frequency would be the column total, that is 180, into row total, that is 80, divided by the grand total. So 120 into 80 by 300. Okay. So once we have calculated the set of observed frequency and the expected frequencies, we take the difference of that and square the difference. That is, if the observed frequency is 20, and the expected frequency is 32, then 20 minus 32 is minus 12. You square that, you will get 144. Okay, 20 minus 32 minus 12 is the result. Square that and you will get 144. Okay, so like this, we calculate the difference and square it for all sections. And then this result, we divide it by the expected frequency and then add them up together to get the chi-square statistic. That means this 10.516 is a result of 144 divided by 32 plus 144 divided by 48 divided by 100 divided plus 100 divided by 60 plus 100 divided by 90 plus 4 divided by 28 plus 4 by 44. Okay, so this is the chi-square statistic or the test statistic of the chi-square test. Now we need to find out the corresponding chi-square critical at level of significance, which is given here as 5%, that is alpha is equal to 0.05. And then we have to calculate the degrees of freedom. Now the degrees of freedom, as you see, that it is a 3x2 matrix. 3x2 matrix in the sense that there are 3 rows and 2 columns. So the corresponding degrees of freedom would be number of rows minus 1 into number of columns minus 1. So here we have 3 minus 1, that is the number of rows minus 1 into number of columns minus 1, that is 2 minus 1. So when we multiply that, you get degrees of freedom equal to 2. Now let's see how to read chi-square critical from a chi-square distribution table. So if you see here, the chi-square distribution table, okay, it's always positive because the term chi-square is always positive. Okay, so you have to look at only one side. So hence this particular test is a one-tailed test. Okay, so your critical region would be only on one side. So to read the chi-square critical value, what you need to do is specify the alpha value, that is 0.05, okay, and the corresponding degrees of freedom 2, the intersection of that would be giving you the chi-square critical value. Okay, so here in this case, degrees of freedom equal to 2 and chi-square at alpha equal to 0.05, okay, we get the chi-square critical value as 5.991. So comparing the chi-square statistic and the chi-square critical, that means when we compare that, we find that the chi-square statistic is greater than the chi-square critical. Hence, you can see that the chi-square statistical value is falling in the rejection region, and hence we have enough evidence to reject the null hypothesis. So if we reject the null hypothesis, okay, it means that we are rejecting the statement saying illness is independent of smoking. So if we are rejecting illness is independent of smoking, so we need to conclude it as illness is not independent of smoking. Now let's say instead of a critical value approach, you want to use a p-value approach. Now if you are doing manually, the p-value approach can be done by finding out the ranges for the p-values. So how do we find that? So here we have chi-square statistic as 10.516. So you can see for corresponding to 2 degrees of freedom, 10.516, okay, will fall in the range of chi-square at 0.010 and chi-square at 0.005. What it means to say is the p-value ranges between 0.005 to 0.010. Okay. So this itself indicates that this p-value is very much less than 0.05, which is the alpha value, and hence from p-value approach, we can again find that there is enough evidence to reject the null hypothesis. That is, if p value is less than alpha, okay, then we can say that there is enough evidence to reject the null hypothesis. So chi-square test of independence is quite simple. We can just calculate the expected frequency, find out the difference from the observed frequency, square it and divide the result from the expected frequency, sum up all the sections of that result, and you get the chi-square statistic. Calculate the chi-square critical from the chi-square distribution table, and you can compare chi-square statistic and chi-square critical, and depending upon whether chi-square statistic is greater than chi-square critical, we can either reject the null hypothesis or accept the null hypothesis. In this particular problem, you could see that chi-square statistic was greater than critical, chi-square critical value, so thereby indicating that there is a rejection region in which the chi-square statistic will fall into. Okay, hence there was enough evidence to reject the null hypothesis. Thank you.